I got my workbench back and a fresh coat of paint, but in order to make that happen, I needed to finish the thing that's been occupying it for the last 4 months. The turret tailstock is done, and I'm going to go over what it took to make that happen today. Hey, it's Pete. Welcome back to the workshop. So when we last visited this project, I had stripped, sanded, filled, and primed the top of the turret. And since then, I've gone on to strip and prime the base of the turret. I wanted to experiment a bit with this paint additive called Penetrol. It's supposed to help eliminate brush strokes, and as near as I can tell, it's basically a more chemically version of boiled linseed oil. It has the same warnings you would get with linseed oil about saturated rags being susceptible to spontaneous combustion. I was curious if it would remove enough of the brush strokes to give me a finish I'd be happy with. I figured it was safe to experiment with the turret base, as it was mostly hidden and a much rougher casting to begin with. Overall, I would have to say it did a decent job of leveling out the finish. One thing I did notice is that it extends the drying time beyond what the untreated paint typically takes. I believe this is going to affect the recoat time as well. In my experiments, I actually had some paint failure that I attribute to putting a second coat on too soon. I ended up needing to strip the paint and starting over. So I started the cleanup and repair on this Enco Hex turret tailstock as a fill-in project about 4 months ago when work on the Centroid Acorn milling machine retrofit had stalled. At the time, I did not know what I was going to do with the spindle motor. Well, that project is back on track and rapidly approaching completion. But all this time, I've been working around the disassembled parts of the turret tailstock. I decided it was time to get it put back together before I started losing pieces. Now, fortunately, nothing was broken on this turret, just jammed with chips, a few munged up threads, and a missing screw or two. Mostly just needed a good cleanup. Prior to reassembly, I cleaned out any paint that had snuck under my tape job, filed and stoned away any dings, and rechased all the threads. I laid out all the parts to make sure I hadn't lost anything and then began reassembling the lower half of the turret. The mechanism down here is responsible for indexing the turret head over to the next position when the turret lock has been released. This small ramped piece is what releases the turret lock. Now, priming the top of the turret revealed some spots that required a bit more touching up. Laying down the primer creates a consistent surface finish that makes the imperfections stand out. I mixed up some more of the metal glaze and filled and sanded those spots. During the glazing, I didn't worry too much about the bores in the castings for the cup oilers, so I went back to clean them out before the final painting. And so I didn't continue to have this issue, I found some plugs to cap these holes prior to putting on another coat of primer. To paint the top of the turret, I ended up taking it back to the spray room at the shop I have access to. I decided to use one of the Harbor Freight HVLP spray guns. This is the one you can get on sale for under $10 with a coupon. I've seriously paid more than that for a paintbrush that I ended up throwing away. I think the orifice was maybe just a bit smaller than it should have been for this paint, but I'm still happy with how it turned out. When the paint had finished drying, I removed all the tape and cleaned up any paint that had snuck underneath, stoned all the exposed metal surfaces, chased all the threaded holes, and cleaned out any of the bored holes. I found some replacement ball oilers on eBay. These are 8mm and a pretty good match for the original. I just drove them in with a wooden dowel to avoid damaging anything. Putting this back together required a bit of extra thought. I couldn't just put it back together the way I took it apart. Due to the tapered pin holding the gear on the end of this shaft, I had to index everything 180 degrees from the position it was in during disassembly so that the tapered pin could be driven in from the proper side. I marked everything with a Sharpie so I wouldn't lose track of what I was doing. When I put the turret back on, I had to ensure it was clocked correctly to agree with the position of the indexing mechanism underneath. From there on, the reassembly was fairly straightforward. I wasn't able to remove the original drive screws that held the machine's name tag on the top of the turret, and I decided rather than making a mess digging into the top, I would just drill two new holes. First, I used a small bit to drill the aluminum plate. I chose this particular cutter because it didn't walk and it made the hole where I want it. Then I switched to a twist drill to finish the holes in the cast iron. This was mostly successful. The remains of the previous screws caused my bit to deflect a bit, but not enough to cause a problem. These drive screws are pretty small and were a bit hard to source, mostly because I didn't know what size I was looking for. Turned out they were 00. This is one area on the turret I may need to revisit. I'm missing two of these depth adjusting screws, and a few of the existing ones are bent, plus the knurling is messed up, but that's something that can be done anytime. The turret had a few broken gib adjusting set screws and missing jam nuts, so I'm replacing all of them with new ones. These are dog point set screws and are a match for the original. I'm happy with how this turned out, but I'm even happier that it's off my workbench. Other than the depth adjusting screws, the only other part that isn't complete are that two of the spokes are missing their ball ends. I may try casting or even overmolding replacements for them in the future. Hopefully I can put this turret to use on a project in an upcoming video. And if you want to see how I printed that replacement Enco machine tag directly on metal, click that link to the left and I'll show you over there.